the coronavirus came to us on the 13th day of March. That's when the first case was reported. When this happened, it's like everything else was paralyzed because there was a lot of fear.
You know, it's a thing that has never happened where churches have been closed, worship centers have been closed for a long time now. We have about between 800 and 900 members coming to church every Sunday. We miss people. We miss members. My name is Reverend Naftaly Gitonga. I serve as the senior pastor here at Lavington United Church. Lavington United Church is a very unique church in this country of Kenya. It is composed of members coming from diverse backgrounds and many denominations coming together to form this church. We began in 1961, and we thank God for that uniqueness. Now, about the COVID-19, I mean, this is a serious phenomenon as we have it now, this country, and of course elsewhere in the world.
When this happened, people kept on anticipating that when it comes to us as Africans, we may be having a lot of difficulties because, you know, our health facilities are not as advanced as what is happening in those other countries in the first world. So we knew that the same coming to us as Africans will be a big challenge. We may not be having the proper mechanisms and processes and systems of fighting the same.
But I want to say, really, the government has done so much, especially the Ministry of Health.
You know, we didn't have the instruments actually of protecting ourselves, the masks, the sanitizing, things like that were lacking, and therefore people are in a lot of fear.
Now, the other issue, out of the tests that have done been done so far, that have tested positive, we don't know the rest of a number of hundreds. We don't know our status. The other thing that has been happening is that a sample is taken, goes to the laboratory, and stays for the next about 24 hours. I mean, the faster it was, then the better for us, so that even the psychological impact will also be reduced. Of course, we are grossly affected as a church. We are used to seeing members oftenly, every Sunday actually. And we worship together. We shake hands outside there every Sunday after every of those services that we have. Worst of all, when we hear that a member has a pastoral issue that needs our address and we can't go out there, that a member in western part of Kenya has lost a relative, you know, you can't even visit that member. We are praying with them over the phones, through text messages, through some emails, but that's not enough. The gift of presence cannot be given that we really feel that we would want to give as a pastoral team. Just being there to see what is happening with our members. We keep on tracing to know how our members are faring on. So the first thing is that we have the district fellowships that are coordinated within, you know, some specific regions. They keep on contacting us and telling us so-and-so is at pains because of some loss, some businesses are collapsing, and things like that. So that we take it upon ourselves as a pastoral team to mention these members by their names and help them to know that somebody is somewhere caring and praying for them. The other thing that we are doing for connection is that we've taken it upon ourselves to prepare sermons, and we deliberately do sermons as if we are in church. Never mind that we are preaching to empty pews, so that it can touch the lives of our members wherever they are. And we encourage them, please pause for a moment and listen to the word of God wherever you are. And that way we are reaching out.
I'm going to read the text that is going to...
They are graciously helping us to know that we are touching their lives. As much as it is affecting us economically, socially, it is impacting to know our psychology in a big, big way. And therefore, I wish and pray that the government again can invest a lot on how people can be taken care of psychologically, even in their houses. When we really fight with this problem and overcome, that's when we are likely to come back to church. And therefore, as a church, it's my prayer and my wish that this pandemic does not really continue affecting us for long. Because that way, the longer we go with it, the longer the impact it has on the livelihood of the people of the nation and the membership of the church here. So I pray and wish that God in heaven will hear us as a nation and bring this to an end as quickly as possible. And pray that God is going to come in and heal us.